What do you get when you put a feminine touch on HTC's high quality design? It's the HTC Rhyme, and this is the video review from fandroid.com. Hey guys, it's Kevin here with fandroid.com, and today we're taking a look at the HTC Rhyme for Verizon. This is a phone designed with the fairer sex in mind, and it comes with a number of accessories, which are a main selling point, but we'll get to that later. So now let's just take a look at the hardware real quick. At first glance, what you'll notice is that HTC has chosen to go with this royal purple color, and it's got a soft touch feel to the case with a little metal accent here. So it's a very sturdy feeling phone. It's got a 3.7-inch screen. You have your four Android soft keys at the bottom. Up top, you have the VGA front-facing camera, the power on-off button and standby, 3.5mm headset jack, and then a little noise-canceling microphone there. There's the microphone on the bottom. The sides remain pretty sparse. Over on the left side here, we have a little flap that you can pull down, and in there you're going to see the USB port for micro USB. The right side features a volume rocker. Looking around at the rear of the device, you'll see a number of things back here. You'll notice it's got these three kind of connectors. These are contact charging points that connect in with the dock, so you don't have to plug it into a charger, just drop it in the dock. We've got the rear speaker there, a 5-megapixel camera capable of 720p video recording. There is an LED flash, and this is also autofocus. The Rhyme is definitely not the most powerful handset that HTC has released lately. It's got a single core 1 GHz processor inside, but it gets 768 megabytes of RAM to go along with it. The Rhyme comes with a 1600 milliamp battery, but it's non-removable. You can get the back cover off though by pulling down and removing, and that'll give you access to the micro SD card. The HTC Rhyme is an Android 2.3 phone, that's Android Gingerbread, and it's running HTC's custom Sense UI. This is one of the first phones to carry the latest version of Sense, which is version 3.5, and you'll see it carries over some of the same features that we've seen in previous releases. You can do the quick app unlock by dragging an icon to that little unlock circle. It'll launch right into the app. In this case, we went into the camera. Or you can just pull the ring up to unlock the whole phone, and you'll see the HTC Sense interface right there. You'll notice in this version of Sense that a lot of things, again, are pretty similar. We've got the 3D kind of carousel that you can spin through there, but you'll also notice that some things have changed a lot. We have, for instance, at the bottom, we have two new launcher icons. We've got your phone dialer, which will just take you into the dialer there, and then we've got an apps tray that launches out here. Apps are organized between your frequently used, all apps, downloaded apps from the market. Taking a look at the notification bar drop-down, you'll see we've got the same sort of thing, our notifications, also the quick settings. We saw this in the last version of HTC Sense, that'll let you turn things on and off. And now we're getting recently used apps up here, so we kind of have a little multitasking tray up there where we can just recall apps that we have used recently. The next thing I'm going to show you guys is something that a lot of people have been asking for with HTC Sense for a while, and that's the ability to remove and edit the number of home screens you have. You aren't stuck with the maximum 7. The phone starts off with 7. If you double tap the home button there, you'll bring up this screen, and you can see you can press and hold to edit. You can rearrange. You long press these and you can rearrange where they go. You can put that one up there if you want. You can grab any and drag down to the trash can and delete it. You just can't delete that main one, that one in yellow there, that's your main home screen. But see, we could take this down and delete it down to 5. And you'll see there's just these 5 home screens to flip through here. Which is useful if you're the kind of person that doesn't use a lot of widgets or a lot of on-screen sort of things like that. There are plenty of new widgets and updates in HTC Sense 3.5 for you to take advantage of, however, including, you'll see here, these little pop-out menus for various apps. HTC has also done a bit to visually refresh the browser. You'll see that the color scheme incorporates a little bit more gray. And if we go into our bookmarks window, you'll just take a look at the kind of the new style that we have. Our panels there, our tiles to pick your websites from. It gives you a little preview and just your different features here. So you see here we've loaded up fandroid.com. Just take a look at how the browser responds. Pretty much like you'd expect from the HTC Sense browser. Very responsive when flicking through pages, zooming in, clicking on content, loading pretty quick with Verizon's network. This isn't a 4G phone, it's still just on Verizon's 3G network, but still pretty quick. So let's real quick take a look at what HTC has done with the camera. pretty much your standard Sense camera here with a few little additions. We've got these effects that we can work with, and these will give you real-time effects actually while you're using it, which is kind of cool. You can get a preview of what it's going to look like. Just various effects that we have. Dots. Get a little vintage photograph, very much that kind of Instagram look if you want that. So this is cool for anyone who likes to kind of get those more artistic, experimental photographs, and I think that's a pretty cool option to have there, especially with the real-time preview to see what the photo is going to look like. Now the phone does have a front-facing camera. We can flip it around just by pressing that button. And then pressing that. You'll see there I am. And they'll even let you put effects onto the front-facing camera, which is neat. Now let's get an idea of how quick this will snap a picture off. Let's just hit the shutter button. And it's pretty quick. It's not super responsive, but I mean, you're gonna get it almost instantaneously. So there's a big improvement there with camera speed. So let's just get an idea of how quickly we could snap off a picture. So we grab our camera icon, drag it in there. We're into the camera, and we're snapping. So it could shave off a few seconds, but it's not bad at all. Pretty quick to get in there and get a picture going, so you don't miss the moment that you're trying to capture on film. Overall, the quality could be a little bit better of the actual images taken, and we'll show a little bit of those in the article, the review. You can check out some samples. But not too dissatisfied with the camera for the features it packs and for the kind of the speed of the shutter and the various things. Very good camera. So that's our look at the HTC Rhyme for Verizon. It's a very well-designed handset, a very sturdy handset, and it works very well. It's not going to be for everyone. It's not going to be for the hardware freak that wants that dual-core processor or the 4G LTE modem inside. It's great for the group they're marketing towards, women. It's got that nice purple color. It's not going to be for people who don't like purple. I mean, it's a great handset for anybody, really, male or female, but if you're not a purple person, it might not be for you. So that's it. I believe it's available for $199 now from Verizon, and thanks for watching.